Hi guys, in this video we're going to tackle queries in more detail. And this is the table I got with the cars I have and their different data to those cars. And now we're going to build several queries based on that table. And we go to create. And I think I mentioned that before in a previous video, you have a query wizard, but it's much more faster. And it's much faster and much more effective by using going to query design. And once I click on that, I have a new query and I have here a small dialogue allowing me to insert table or tables I wish to base my query on. And I can also insert queries I've previously done into that query. So in a query, you can insert either a table or another query you did earlier. We're going to use tables and we're going to use cars. And there it is. I've got my table in here. Now, I have already set the table on which my query is based. Now, I wish to insert the fields. And a query, the design of a query is divided into two sections. The upper section here contains the table or tables or queries upon which your new query is based. And here, that lower bit is then where the fields are inserted. So basically, if I need now manufacturer, there are three ways to insert a field. One is to drag it down here. It is in. Another way, let me just, because I see here there's a scroll, let me just extend the length of that table so I can see all fields at once. And let me just enlarge that bit here. Right. Now, another way to insert a field is basically double-click it. So type, I just double-click on type, and it's in here. And a third way to insert a field, which is basically go in that first cell and just use the drop-down and click or select the field that you wish, okay? Now, this lower area here is also called QBE, section of a query design. And QBE stands for query by example. What I'm doing, I'm building my query by dragging and dropping everything. There's another way to build a query, and basically it's through SQL. SQL, structured query language, is basically the language in which queries can be built. And SQL is basically not only used in Access, but in a lot of professional databases like MySQL, SQL Server, PostgreSQL, etc. So knowing SQL, it would be a great benefit, not only for your Access career. And if I go here to view, you can see here I've got the SQL view. And if you go there, you can see what we have already done. We said that it says select. It depends the table's name in front of each field. Now let's go back to the design just to see. We have three fields. We inserted three fields: the field manufacturer, the field type, and the field variant from the table cars. And if we go and look at the SQL thing, it says basically the same thing: select manufacturer from table's car, from the cars table. So that's why it says cars.manufacturer. Select the type field, the field type, and select the field variant. All of them from, obviously here, from the table cars, from cars. Okay, from the table cars. So I can now add more fields here in my SQL, or I can go back to my design and add the fields there. Okay, because I can show you how to do it in SQL. Let me just get the name of the next field. Let's say doors. So I just go here and just set a comma and then write cars.doors. Okay, so, and if I go back to my design view, I should have now a fourth column at the bottom in that QBE area with doors in it. Let's see. And you see there's doors. This one I inserted via SQL and not via dragging and dropping here. Okay, now, if I wish to have, start price, but I want it in front of doors. How do I do that? Well, I just drag it and place it on doors, and that lets it, that puts it left to doors. You see, doors just shifted one to the right. Okay, great. Now, these are all the fields I wish to have in my query. And now here you see the first point or objective of a query. It is basically so that you can you don't have to insert all of your table's data. You just select the specific fields you wish to have in that query, and that's it. And let's view our data. And there you go. I just got that. And I can, let's say, if I don't wish to have doors, I just click here. Just, you see, there's a small, let me just do it again. There's a small a line or row here, which is gray. If you see your cursor changes into that downward arrow, once you click on that, you select the whole row and just go to delete, and you get rid of that. So now I only got four fields to display. And if I go to my view, to my data view, I can see those four fields. So here you see the first objective of queries is, you know, I don't have to show every field I got on the table. I just want to see specific fields. Okay, let's go back to the design. Now let's tackle sorting. If I, let's say, wish to sort by manufacturer, it's very easy. You have here, you see now here in the QBE area, you have the first line or row is fields. There are all the fields you wish to have in your query. The second row contains the tables from where your fields come. In this case, we only have one table, so they all come from the same table. The third line or row is sorting, and I wish to sort by manufacturer. So that's very easy. You can either take ascending, descending, or not sorted. Let's say ascending. And then I can have a second key, which is basically by type, descending. So what does that mean? That means all manufacturers are sorted in an ascending order. And if you have several records with the same manufacturer, these records with the same manufacturer get then sorted by type, and this time in a descending order. So they're sorted by manufacturer in ascending. Cars from the same manufacturer get then among themselves sorted by type in a descending order. Let's see how that data looks. And the data looks like that. You let me just go back to my, well, here you see, I can explain that. I might as well explain that. The fourth line is show. If you take off the check of that box, that field will not be shown. That's why we only saw type. Let me check that back in, and now I should be able to see manufacturer exactly. So now we see manufacturer sorted in ascending order. First, you have the Fords, and then you have the Opals, and so on. And then the Fords among themselves are sorted by type in a descending order. That's why you have the S-Max at the top, then the Mondeos, then the K for Kuga, K-A, Ka, and then the Galaxy, and so on. See, and that's the way our sorting works. Now, one thing to remember is that sorting axis sorts from left to right. So basically, it first sorts by manufacturer because that's the leftmost sorting key here, and then it takes type. Okay, now a question comes up: how can I sort first by type and then by manufacturer? Because like I said, it only axis only always sorts from left to right. So in this case, first manufacturer and then type. So if I wish to sort first by type and then by manufacturer, I would have to move type to the left of manufacturer, and then I click that and just move it to the left. Now our data would be sorted first by type in a descending order, and then by manufacturer, and then with cars of the same type, these get sorted by manufacturer in an ascending order. Let's see. You see, first the type is sorted, and though obviously here in our case you will not see the action of the second key because all types come from the same manufacturer. You see, they all come from the same manufacturer. We will not see the action of the second key. Now, let's try it with a different thing. Let's take the start price to the left, and let's do that descending. Okay, so now we will have cars first sorted by the start price in a descending order. Then cars with the same start price, they get sorted by the type in a descending order. And let's remove that third key because we don't need it, because all cars of the same type belong anyways to the same manufacturer. Right, let's see now. So now you can see first by start price, and you see that then cars with the same price, if cars have got the same price, these get sorted by the type in a descending order. Okay? Now, comes another question. Okay, that's good and fine, but I wish to have my data shown in the following order. First the manufacturer, and then the type, and start price way back here. But I would like to have that sorting. How do I do that? You see, now I've got a, let's say, a bigger problem. I wish to have the sorting in that order. However, I would like to have in my view, first of all, the manufacturer, then the field type, then the variant, and then the start price. How do I do that? Well, there are certain ways to do it. One way is we want to have first manufacturer, then the start price. Then the type. Okay, let's shift that guy over here in this order, type, and then start price at the back. Now, if I do it like this, then my sorting doesn't work anymore because now it sorts first by type and then by start price. Now, one way to solve this dilemma would be to insert a copy of start price right up front and take that checkbox off and make the sorting descending. Take that sorting off here, we don't need it. So now it gets first done by start price, sorted by start price, and then by type. You see, so I've got my sorting right, first by start price, and then by type, and shown will be this order, manufacturer, type, variant, start price. See, so I got the same sorting as before, but now it shows me the fields in the order I wish to see them. Now, that's one way of doing it. And a much neater way of doing things would be, let me delete that first. One neater way of doing it is to say, okay, you know what? This is the order of fields I wish to see, and I wish to see them in that order. Now, once I'm done with that, I can insert then the copies of those fields I wish to sort by. So you say, I wish to sort first by start price in a descending order, okay? Start price, don't show it, just take off the checkbox and say descending. Then, the next thing would be, let's say, type, same thing. Type to the right of start price because that would be the second key. And then in this case, I say ascending, for instance. And again, important is not to show that, because if I show that, I would have the field type twice in there, which is not very good. So now I have a very clean interface here. First of all, the fields which are to be shown in that order. And then after that, I have again the same fields, again copies of that fields if you wish. In this case, not shown, but these fixed order. The only reason I am inserting these two fields here are for the sorting, to get my sorting right, and they're not shown. So you see here the point of that show checkbox, because often in a query, you would need to have that field inside that query, yet you do not want to show that field in the query itself. And that's why you have this checkbox. And if you look at it, we get the same result as before. The order of the fields is the way I want it, yet the sorting is, again, the way I want it without disrupting the view order of those fields. And if we look at the SQL code of all what we did, it's like, we know that one, what that one means. It means select manufacturer, type, variant, and start price from cars. And you notice here, because start price is more than one word, it gets put in not curly brackets, what do you call them? I forgot the name, but you see those brackets in those brackets. So if you have field names containing multiple words, you have to put them in those square brackets. And you see here, that's our sorting. Order by first start price descending, and then by type. Because we are sorting by type in an ascending order, you don't have to add here ASC for ascending. It is default. In SQL, default is ascending. But when you're doing descending, you'd have to add this bit here. Okay. Great. Let's go back to our design view. So basically, it doesn't matter whether you write your query in SQL or you generate it in here in the design view. When we are further down the line with this series in Access, we'll be doing a lot of VBA, and we can then have our VBA code generate this SQL, which in turn generates the query we need for our project. So SQL is quite an important aspect in our Access development, and not only for Access development, but a lot of professional databases, as I mentioned before, a lot of professional databases use SQL to control and generate queries. Right, let me go back to the design. So basically, now we have seen what we do with queries, or what we can do with queries. In a future video, I'm gonna show you something else and something very important you can do with queries, which is basically filtering. But I don't wanna overextend this video now, but we're gonna do, in a future video, we're gonna be dealing with filtering in queries. Again, a very important theme. But right now, you are in a position to create your own queries based on the tables you wish to have, or based on the data you wish to have in your query, and you're able to sort that data in your query the way you want it. And one important aspect you see in queries is, first of all, you can sort them the way you want it, and second of all, you can insert the fields you wish in your queries. You do not have to insert all the tables fields in your query.